Hi guys, Marilia here. So today I filmed this makeup look, just like a simple look that I usually wear every day. I tried a couple new products out, so yeah, if you want to watch how I got this look, continue watching.
I'm gonna start off by moisturizing my skin with the Shea Moisture Coconut Oil. I apply this all over my skin. I try to avoid my eyebrows though, because I find when I apply this on my eyebrows that the dip brow pomade that I use, it wipes off easily, so I avoid my eyebrows when I apply this, or any moisturizer for that matter. And then I'm just going to move on with my lip balm, and I'm going to use the Blissex one. It's like my go-to, the one I always reach for. So I'm going to start off the video by doing my eyebrows. I just like to comb them out with a spoolie first to get all the brows moving in one direction, and then I move on to filling them in, and I use the Anastasia Dip Brow Pomade in the color dark brown, and I just start off by applying a line on the bottom half of my brow. Then I just, you know, move on to the top portion, fairly explainable. As you see in the video, I'm just going to move on to my other eyebrow here. Oh, also, you can disregard the white stuff in my hair. It's just the conditioner that I use. It always occurs when I apply gel with that conditioner, just the residue, but it always dries up clear. So just go ahead and disregard that completely. So yeah, I'm going to move on to clean them up with my NARS concealer in the shade Amande. And using this small concealer brush, I'm just going to clean up the bottom half of my eyebrows just to make them more sharper, clean up any mistakes I might have made. And I'm also going to use this to cover up a little scar that I have in the middle of, well, in between my eyebrows. yeah, and then I use the same brush to just blend out that concealer shade so I don't have any harsh lines there. And then I'm going to blend it out also with my fingers just to remove any excess product I may have there. And then moving on from that, I'm going to conceal using my MAC concealer in the shade NC45. This is my first time using it, and I actually like the coverage that it gave me. I wish that I got a shade that was like one shade lighter, because when I blend this out, it blends out to like my skin tone, which is fine. I could just apply a highlight to it, but overall, I like the concealer, and I'm just going to blend it out with a damp beauty blender. I'm just going to blend it out everywhere basically, and I'm going to take the excess from the sponge and I'm going to blend it out a little bit on my forehead, down the bridge of my nose, and my chin. There's not like a lot extra on the sponge itself, but I still just like to do that extra step. And you just want to make sure that when you blend very well to not grab any harsh lines you may see. And then using my LA Girl Pro Concealer in the shade Cocoa, I'm going to use that to contour my nose. So I start off by contouring the bottom, and then I just move down to the sides of my nose. If you guys want a more in-depth tutorial of how I contour my nose, or even of how I do my eyebrows, go ahead and let me know down in the comment section, and I'll be sure to film that for you. So yeah, fairly explainable, like I said, with the eyebrows. Just two little lines down, and I do a little line across just to give it a more button-like effect. And I use my damp beauty blender just to blend that out. And then I'm going to use my Laura Mercier translucent powder. This is the first time I'm using this as well. And I'm going to apply this just where I applied my concealer, basically. So I'm going to apply this underneath my eyebrows. I'm sorry, underneath my eyes. And then I'm going to apply the excess from the sponge. I'm going to apply it on my forehead, the bridge of my nose, in my chin. And I'm also going to reverse contour by applying this powder right below my contour just to make it really sharp. So to contour, I'm going to use this dark brown Maybelline eyeshadow, and I'm going to use this dense contouring brush just to pat that in place. And then I'm going to take my L'Oreal Infallible contour palette, and I'm going to take the contour shade, obviously. This is a more warm color, so I like to apply this on top of the darker color, and I just blend those two out together. I just like the finish that it gives me. So I apply this, obviously, on my cheeks where I'm going to contour, and then I apply the excess right below my lips just to make my lips look a little bit more fuller, a little bit more poutier. Then I'm going to dust away the excess of the powder that I have on my face using this, Bristol brush, I believe? Yeah, a bristle brush? I'm sorry, drew a blank, I forgot the name. Using that brush, I'm just going to, dust away the excess powder. I'm just going to basically like blend out everything on my face, make sure everything looks seamless. I'm going to go back in with that contouring brush just to make sure that nothing, once again, looks too harsh. And then I'm going to set the contour on my nose using that same L'Oreal shade. I'm not really adding any more of a contour. I'm just setting that same contour that I have there, just so it doesn't move or wipe away or anything like that. And then moving on, I'm going to apply my eyelashes, I believe. I'm going to set my eyebrows first before applying the lashes. I'm going to use the Maybelline Clear Brow Gel. I always use this to set my eyebrows. I've been doing this for years. It's like $5. It's a great price and it works really good with me. Some people might not like the consistency because it is like a gel-like, but I don't mind it and it works for me, like I said. So the lashes that I'm showing you here are lashes that I custom made myself. So if you want to know how I did that, like I said before, just let me know in the comment section and I will do a little tutorial of how I custom make my own lashes for my own personalization. And I'm using tweezers and the black duo gel to not sorry not black duo gel sorry I'm using the black duo glue to apply the lashes. Fairly simple to apply the lashes, just apply them right in the middle of the eye of your eyelid, and then of your lash line, yes, and then I just tack on the ends to the eyelid as well. I'm sorry, lash line as well. And when that glue is dried, I'm just going to take my Better Than Sex concealer and I'm going to my Better Than Sex mascara. What's wrong with me today? I'm going to apply that on the bottom and the top lashes. Then moving on, I'm going to get my glow kit from Anastasia Beverly Hills as well. And I'm going to take the color Browns and Summer, and I like to mix these two together just to get my own color payoff. And I'm going to make basically a little exclamation mark on my nose. So I'm going to do just the tip and the bridge. Then I'm going to apply it on my brow bone and my inner inner tear ducts, and also my cupid's bow. And I'm going to take this contouring brush. I like this to highlight instead of contouring, because for contouring it's not dense at all, but it's a bigger brush so it's able to pick up more product. So I prefer to use this rather than a fan brush to apply my highlighter. So yeah, just apply it on the bridge of my cheeks, and then I apply a little bit on my foreheads as well. And then I'm just going to take that same bristle brush and I'm just going to blend it out a little bit more. I'm just going to blend out the Norse contour as well. And then I'm going to move on with my lips. So for lips, I'm going to use MAC lip liner in the color Chestnut. I'm going to line my lips, and then on my bottom lip, I'm just going to draw three little lines in the middle and two on the sides to help make my lips look a little bit fuller. Then I'm going to take the NYX Butter Gloss and the number 14, which is the color Madeline. And I'm just going to apply that right over. And I'm going to be sure to blend out the outer corners where I have my lip liner. I just like the way a dark lip liner and a light like lip color looks together on dark skin. I'm just a fan. And yeah, I'm just going to set my face with the MAC Fix Plus spray. And that finishes up the look for today. So I'm sorry for my little mistakes. But yeah, this is the look. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Make sure to press the like button and subscribe, and I will see you all in the next video.